the sky to the Magic Kingdom.
Myself, I am Mr. Noah Locke, city clerk here on Main Street, USA. It's time to gather around, everyone, because in just a few moments, we are going to officially open the Magic Kingdom. But before we can open the park, we have to wait for Mickey and the gang to arrive from Toontown on the Walt Disney World Railroad. You see, they've been very busy this morning, getting the Magic Kingdom ready to open just for you. Greetings, everyone. Let's say hi to our special guests.
Hi there!
Good to see you!
Let's welcome our new friend.
Hello! Welcome!
Good morning from all of us here in the Magic Kingdom. On the Walt Disney World steam train, and then help us open the park by throwing some special magic pixie dust. Is everyone ready?
Face me.
up ahead. These natives are friendly, so everybody get ready. We're all going to wave and say hi to the pygmies as we approach. Everybody, let's wave and say hi to the pygmies. I don't see...
Iago?
That looked like a cat landed. Zero.
That's Zazu. Be forewarned, Iago. You cannot toy with the enchanted tiki room.
What are you squawking about?
Pardon me, Monsieur Iago, but I am afraid that your friend is right.
This is Aladdin. To make sure your magic carpet ride is a safe one, I want to remind you to stay seated with your seatbelt fastened nice and tight throughout your flight. And hey, everybody, make sure you keep your hands, arms, feet and legs inside, and be sure to watch your kid. Why isn't the front row to push up or pull down on the left? To make the car pass forward and back, why isn't the back row? Why isn't the front row to push up or pull down on the left? To make the car pass forward and back, why isn't the back row?
We're on the rails again. Welcome aboard the Walt Disney World Railroad. To ensure a safe ride, remember to stay seated with your hands, arms, feet, and legs inside the train. And please, watch your kids.
Para su seguridad, permanezca sentado y mantenga las manos, brazos, pies y piernas dentro del tren. Y cuide a los pequeños. Gracias.
Right now, we're passing through the foothills of Big Thunder Mountain and the tiny town of Tundra. Things just ain't been the same here since them spirits took over the mountain and spooked all the mine trains. We're entering the back bridge of Virginia now, home of Pocahontas and the Powhatan Indians. In fact, if you listen carefully, you can even hear the spirit of Pocahontas singing to John Smith. Steam-powered trains that ride these rails daily here at the Magic Kingdom. These hired horses are the descendants of the pioneers of the rail that crisscrossed our growing nation more than a century ago.
Hey, you might have seen Wilson in that video. He's a great guy. He flies around, keeps an eye on things on there. There's game spotting guys right on tightly to them, though. We can't stop. They fall out. We'll get some great wildlife photos on here. And it's always a new adventure on here, too. Been on here before. These animals are on the right side. That's an Okapi antelope over there on the right side of us there. He has the stripes like a zebra related to the draft.
Oh, there he is.
Very shiny animal, too, the Okapi. They weren't even discovered until 1901. They have that tongue like a draft, too.
Okay.
Tiny bit. Of course, sometimes we'll see black rhinos out here. One of the most endangered species in all of Africa. A little less than 4,000 of them left. And these are pink-backed pelicans, yellow-billed storks down here by the watering hole. These pelicans, they live in colonies. They all... Yellow-billed storks, they feed on fish, crabs, and small snakes. There, on the left side here. So Timbo can weigh up to about 5,000 pounds. Look at that birth, about 85 pounds. And they'll spend most of their day in the rivers to keep those bodies from overheating. They come out at night and feed along the riverbanks. When they do, they can eat about 150 pounds of grass.
Oh, there's so many of them. Look how many.
Yeah, stay out of the water, 5 to 8 minutes at a time. Crocodiles. baobab trees. Yeah, we'll see more of those on the savannah. That's where we're headed right now, into the savannah. Now the savannah, as you see it out here, pretty much what the animals make of it. The elephants, they like the neck over the trees. They eat the leaves and bark off the trees. Horns get about 5 to 6 feet long. Yeah, look at the horns on that one. 5-6 foot long horns on the Ankole. They're a domestic type of cattle. They're also known as the Watusi cattle. They're named after the Watusi tribe. And these are sable antelope out there too. Those dark brown antelope, those are sables. Sables have curved horns that grow about 50 to 60 inches long. And the sable antelope is the official emblem of the Harambe Wildlife Reserve. A lot of termite mounds around this area here, these cone-shaped mounds that you see coming out of the ground here on both sides of the area. These are termite mounds. Elephants use termite mounds as a scratching post. They migrate through the Serengeti 1.5 million each year. And a wildebeest calf can stand and run in 5 to 10 minutes after they're born. There's the elephants here. We are approaching elephant country here. Now, bull elephant males, they weigh up to 12,000 pounds. A female can weigh up to about 6,000 to 8,000 pounds. And they can eat up to 300 pounds of food per day. A couple of them right here. Yeah, we are in elephant country here. Clues to the whereabouts, a big red or a little red?
I have not seen them today. Try the red clay pit.
Being built a while ago to a new calf.
He does bathe in the same red clay pit as his mama. So I name him Little Red.
Elephants are wonderfully social creatures. They have moods, sympathy.
They have a lifespan 60 to 70 years old. The little ones will stay with their mothers sometimes up to 13 years. During that time, they're always learning. They learn what to eat, where all the watering holes are at, how to get along with all the other elephants. We'll get a little close up of the baby elephant back there.
He's so cute.
And flamingo right here too. Greater flamingo. Flamingo chicks, so when they... All right, these are ostrich eggs here on the ground. Largest bird egg in the world. Linus right there too. And they have excellent night vision. 6 times more powerful than humans. The lions weigh up to about 550 pounds, a lioness up to about 400 pounds. There's a lioness right next to them.
Standing at Magadi Gorge, block of the east end. If you come in from the west, we could trap them.
Please, civil one, we need your help.
Okay, guys, we're going to help out. We'll get some poachers. These are eland, Patterson's eland right here, these large antelope. 6 feet tall from the ground to their shoulders. Large eland right up ahead. Yeah, this doesn't look good here. Hey, Wilson, we're at the crossroads. Gates been smashed through.
Keep going, Simbawan. We are landing now.
Okay, guys, we're leaving the reserve. Hang on tight to the kids. Keep a lookout for poachers. Ah, poachers, hang on, guys. All right, here's their camp right in front of us, sir. A lot of poaching going on there. Elephant tusks, rhino horns. All right, we'll keep going here, guys. Hang on.
You forced them into our trap.
The water tap, Big Red. She'll be fine.
Okay. Hey, there's a little red in the back of the truck. He looks okay. All right, we'll see you, Wilson.
See you, Simba One. I have to deliver the baby elephant.
Thanks for helping us save little red and big red. I'll get back up on the road here. Sure. Little run will be okay on the back of the truck there. Hey, looks like we made it. There's the warden's posts. You drop there, it's just a short.
Last line of a movie of Humphrey Bogart and Ingrid Bergman. And classic romance, Casablanca. We're feeling we're not in Kansas anymore. How often can you say that? They were definitely somewhere over the rainbow in one of the most beloved movies of all time, The Wizard of Oz. Which way do we go?
Oh, yeah. Just lost your engine, and action! Check that engine for me. Now pick up the phone, call your captain. Tell him we're going to be taking on just a little bit of water. Keep on talking there for me, Brian. And cut! Guys, looks like there's some planes approaching. Captain, grab those binoculars. Find that plane in the sky. Uh-oh, their crew blocks our enemy fighters coming in at 10 o'clock. You're scared. You're stunned. You're in trouble because he's coming around for another round. Captain, spin that wheel. Get that PT out of there. Deck crew, watch out. Here they come again at 10 o'clock. You guys are scared. Oh, no, guys. It's too late. He's shot through. Captain, pick up the phone. Call your mechanic. Hey, deck crew, stand up for me. Deck crew, what's that coming in off the right side of your boat? Looks like a torpedo. And just when you guys think sounds like more planes are approaching, you stand up, look up, point to the sky, enemy bombers coming in at 12 o'clock. Bombs away, everyone, hit the deck. Congratulations, looks like you guys survived that aerial attack. Wait for you guys, they passed you, but they headed towards the audience.
Oh, yes. Indeed I do. Well then, it is a perfect day.
Every day is a perfect day for a nice
little on collection of characters.
Master will be furious if he finds out what they're up to.
Well, we don't have to tell him, do we?
There is nothing to worry about.
No, nothing. Jump our entire future.
Oh, pish posh. We have guests for dinner.
Thank you, sir.
What are you talking about? What's going on? Come on, Mom.
No kid, dear.
Oh, dear.
No need to worry.
We'll keep it simple.
Thank you.
Oh, another one in the corner over there. Look. Wow, he's coming over here now. What's that?
Is there any more of this, Alex?
Sorry.